Okay, so we're back at it now, working on the staves for the mast. As you can see, we had to change the clamp up procedure a little bit. The weight of the anvil or railroad section just wasn't getting the scarf joints here tight enough. So we put a caul on the bottom, a caul on the top, some wrap so the glue wouldn't stick to the cauls, and went like that. So now the next step is to scrape all the excess squeeze out. We're going to take the belt sander and sand down these joints a little bit, and then we'll start our layout. Okay, so these have been hit with the belt sander now, just real quick to take off the excess glue and any high spots. As you can see, those scarf joints, although they're not super pretty, they came out pretty well. I'm pleased. The jig worked out real nice. I hit the side just a little bit with the sander so you could actually see the seam of the scarf joint. The seam is right there. You can barely make it out. I don't know how well the video is picking it up. That simple little jig did a pretty good job.
So today is March 11th. We're in day two of the build. So we've got our boards all scarfed together for the mast staves. I've got them all cut to 15'5", which is about what I want the finished product to end up to. And we're about to start laying out the staves. Because we want a tapered mast, only over part of it, they're going to be, for the first 40 inches up to this line, they're going to be 1 3/16 inch wide, and then they're going to taper down on both sides to 3/4. That'll give us a 3-inch base when we're done, and a 2-inch top.
Well, welcome back. Today is the Wednesday the 12th, and we're moving on with the mast staves. Okay, so the way we did this is we ran a chalk line as a center line, and the staves taper at this point from 3/4 inch up to this line, which is 40 inches from the end. There'll be a taper up to here. They're 1 3/16 wide, and they stay straight down to the base where the mast will sit in the step, and it's going to be a 3-inch, approximately a 3-inch round from there down. Okay. So I've started the cutting process. I've got two staves done here. I get two each 1x4, and this is my cutting station. I've got it set up on a 12-foot 1x12 here. I clamped my blanks so they're just hanging off the edge of it. Clamp it at the middle and down at the far end. I use my skill saw to saw up to just before the middle clamp. Come back, throw a clamp on this end. Saw to just before the third clamp. Put the second back on and finish my cut.